Hello CTT friends, welcome to this AWS series. In this video, we will discuss about AWS S3 cloud offerings. Primarily, we will talk about what is S3, its different types and feature characteristics, etc. Then we will do hands-on demonstration. There will be many multiple labs, so it will take some time. So I shall create those one after another and we'll make available for you. AWS S3 is really, really useful and simple in concept. You may find very interesting and want to use it regularly as well. Also, if you are planning for AWS certification, you need to understand S3 concept thoroughly. Though it is simple in concept, but there are many things that need your close attention to pass AWS certification. So here is the short summary of AWS S3. Amazon S3 is really convenient to store and retrieve any amount of data at any time from anywhere on the web. S3 provides amazingly durable, high available, secured storage to store any type of objects. Objects, you can consider it as files. So you can think AWS S3 is cloud-based hard drive, and it provides you nice interface, APIs, and command line tools to interact with it. Now in regular life, you use your external hard drive, USB, to store files, right? So similarly, you can use S3 for those purpose as well, and the files will be stored in the cloud somewhere in the AWS data center. There are now multiple companies, like for example, Box, OneDrive, Dropbox. These companies provide services which is based on AWS S3. So using their services, you can avoid using USB external drive altogether. So what they have done, they have created a client software that creates a special folder in your computers, the content of which then synchronized with cloud storage in S3. So if you put a file from your home computer, let's say for example, you can access the same file from your let's say office or university or across from any of your devices. So certainly this removes carrying your external drive, USB, right? So that helps. Now there is one difference when you compare AWS S3 with your external hard drive. Now AWS S3 is object-based storage. You can store any type of objects, files as an object, but you cannot use it as high-performance device, for example, to install operating system or database or any kind of software. You cannot use S3 for that purpose. But you can do it on your external hard drive or USB because those are block-based storage. So AWS S3 is object-based storage. Now let's move to next slide. So basically we will be discussing about AWS S3 key concept. So there are few terminologies that you should be familiar with when learning about S3. First one is object. Objects are the fundamental entities stored in Amazon S3. What does that mean? So in summary, whatever you are putting in S3 as a files or data, you can call it as object. But within AWS domain, objects consist of data and as well as its metadata of your content. Metadata is a set of name value pairs that describes your object or your content. The next one is buckets. A bucket is a container for objects stored in Amazon S3. You can compare it as logical partition of your hard drive. If you are using Windows system, it could be your C drive, D drive, etc. For Linux, it could be root, opt, etc. and so on, right? There are different mount points. So under bucket, you can create your files, folder structure, etc. So in Amazon, we show this bucket using these icons. So if there are no objects in the bucket, then first one. And if there are objects in the bucket, then you use second icon. So one important thing to remember, when you create bucket in AWS S3 service, the bucket name has to be unique across all AWS S3 regions or buckets. So what does that mean? So if someone already created a bucket, you cannot create another bucket with same name. Like computer, you cannot have same drive letter in Windows or mount point in Linux system. So it's similar. So let's, for example, if you create CTT bucket, AWS will generate this access URL. And this part, CTT-bucket, has to be unique across all AWS S3 buckets. Even those buckets are owned by someone else, you cannot use the same bucket name for your bucket. Now friends, next item is regions. Hope you have already watched previous videos where I thoroughly explained about regions. So basically regions are the geographical location where Amazon S3 will store the buckets you create. So you can select a specific region while creating S3 bucket. So all of your content will stay in that region only, unless you explicitly transfer them to another region. For example, if you create a bucket in Mumbai region, you want to store a file in that bucket, so the file will be stored in the Mumbai region only. So Amazon will not transfer that file to somewhere else. But of course, if you explicitly move that file from the Mumbai region to, let's say, for example, London region, it's up to you. Now, next item is keys. A key is the unique identifier for an object within a bucket. Now, it is very simple to understand. Just to note that every object has one and only key that is used to identify that particular object. But of course, there is another part identifying an object within S3, which is a version ID. So the combination of a bucket, key, and version ID uniquely identify one object. So let's move on. Now, next item is version ID. Multiple versions of objects can be stored in Amazon S3. You can put multiple versions of same file. That means you can use the same file name in S3 bucket. If you enable versioning, AWS S3 will keep all these different files of same file name with different version marker. If you use the same file name and update a file, so AWS S3 will automatically create next version of that particular object. Now metadata, right? So it is set of data set that describe the actual stored data. As I mentioned before, that S3 object consists of metadata, which is basically special meaningful summary of data of your actual content or object. For example, created by, updated by, timestamp, these are the data that AWS S3 automatically generates and stored about that particular content. Now, last but most important topic is Amazon S3 data consistency model. So this is really important, guys, and you need to understand it very clearly. So this is basically when you put any files in S3 or try to read it from S3, how S3 will respond to your request. Now, first one is read after write consistency for puts of new objects. So when you write a new object in S3 bucket, you can read this object right after the writing is complete. So even if you are from a different region, you can read it right away. That means it is the immediate consistency. You can read that object right after the write. But while you want to modify or delete any existing data object from S3 bucket, the operation may not perform immediately. So that is where the eventual consistency comes into the picture. So eventual consistency for overwrite, puts, and delete while overwriting objects. So what does that mean? In case of eventual consistency, there is a slight possibility if you make a retrieval request right after you put or delete any object, you may receive old data. But of course, AWS guarantees that there is no way the data will be corrupted or partially retrieved, right? Either you will get it old data or the latest data. So friends, this has been a bit technical so far. So if you want, you can pause the video and take a break or rewatch to digest the S3 concept, whatever we have discussed so far, and come back to continue. Okay, so hopefully you are good now. So let's continue. So what are the different highlights of S3? So I have captured all the important highlights about Amazon S3. So first, it is designed to deliver 99.999999 parcels durability. So it is called 11 nines durability. So that means it is so reliable service that you will hardly lose your data. So maybe in 1,000 years you may lose only one object, that is also highly unlikely. The second one is S3 standard is designed for 99.99% availability, and standard infrequent access is designed for 99.9% availability. So that means it is almost all the time running and available for your use. If I calculate it, it will be hardly 53 minutes maximum when S3 may not be available throughout the year. So basically, Amazon S3 was carefully engineered to meet the requirements for scalability, reliability, speed, low cost, and simplicity as well. So all the non-functional requirement aspect is covered for AWS Amazon S3. And another highlight is you can store any size of object starting from 0 byte to 5 terabyte. So that means your file size can be up to 5 terabyte, which is allowed to be uploaded. And there is no limit of numbers. You can upload any number of files to Amazon S3. AWS S3 also supports SSL encryption of data in transit, and as well as it encrypts data at rest using SHA-256 algorithm. And from security aspect, S3 also has a bucket policy, access control list mechanism. So using those services or features, you can further secure your data. And it also has lifecycle management. So that means basically using lifecycle management feature, you can transfer one object from normal standard S3 storage to, let's say, archival storage. So if you want to archive any files, then you can set a policy that will automatically transfer your files from your normal S3 storage to archive location. And of course, lastly, the Amazon S3 SLA, I will provide all the links below. You can visit those SLA clauses. So what is written in the Amazon S3 SLA? So Amazon S3 SLA provides for a service credit if a customer's monthly uptime percentage is below their service commitment in any billing cycle, they will compensate that. Hello friends, this has been very technical and conceptual topic so far, and this video is getting a bit longer as well. So finishing this here, but in our next topics, we will discuss about different AWS storage types, and we will compare all these features about those storage types. We will also discuss about pricing model, and of course, we'll create hands-on demo, and we'll do different type of labs, and we'll make it available for you. So friends, join me in next videos to discuss all these topics. Meanwhile, please take a break and come back. So thank you, friends. See you in the next video.